Hi guys, my name is Tiffany and welcome back to another video. So in this one I thought I would share with you guys some of the things that I have to do as a nurse just beyond going to work, doing my job, and going home. There's actually a lot of requirements that I have to do to be able to maintain working where I am now. So I know that every hospital is different. I'm only talking about my own personal experience and where I'm currently working right now, but I know a lot of hospitals do have requirements on what you need to be able to maintain working at the place that you're at. So for example, at my hospital and usually at other hospitals, they require you to have certain certifications. So one of them, and usually the main one, is BLS. So we have to be able to maintain our CPR, and usually a lot of hospitals will require you to maintain that every 2 years. Another thing that I have to do is, of course, I work in the NICU, so I have to maintain my NRP. Other hospitals, if you work in pediatrics, requires you to do PALS, and if you work with adults, then usually you'll do your ACLS or something. So every hospital usually requires this from their staff and be able to maintain your certification. And of course, another thing is be able to maintain your RN license. So you have to do CEs or continuing education to be able to maintain your nurse license. And this is of course through the Board of Registered Nursing, and usually hospitals or a lot of institutions will provide you education or clinical hours, or usually they will give you some sort of stipend to be able to use towards continuing education. So at my hospital, we do have clinical ladders, and there's actually different requirements on how to get up the clinical ladder. So as an RN3 now, I currently have a long, extensive checklist on things that I must do to be able to maintain my RN3. So one of them being audits. So I actually do safe to sleep audits, and basically I go through patient information. I actually look through the patient charts, as well as making sure, and I'm teaching and educating the staff and the families on how to do safe to sleep for their babies. So we always make sure to go around the unit, make sure the head of the bed is flat, the patient is supine, and also there's no excess things in the bed. So that being blankets or toys, etc. So that's one of the things that I have to do as a requirement for my clinical nurse 3. So since I do work in a magnet hospital, another thing that I have to do is research. So we actually have to look up articles and make sure that our hospital policies is following current research. And so there's a lot of things that we have to do. We usually do them as groups, or you can do them individually. We find current research on the practices that we're currently doing at our hospital and making sure we are following along the current research. So another thing that I have to do in order to maintain my RN3 is join a committee. So in my unit, we actually have quite a few different committees that you can join. I currently am part of the mentor committee at my hospital, and mentoring is something that I am very passionate about. Ever since nursing school, we had created a mentor program there, and then now I do a mentor program at the hospital I'm working at now. So it's something that I'm very passionate about, and there's a lot of different ones that you can join. We do have ones that are like developmental for staff, as well as developmental for the patients, and there's all different ones that you can join. And there's also other things that my checklist requires us to do. One of them being, if you do volunteer hours, you can also gain points for that as well. So usually our hospital requires us to have a certain number of volunteer hours, and for us it's 16. So basically what I have to do is be able to maintain volunteer service anywhere in the hospital, or you can do a community outreach as well. So usually I like to join little clinics that we have for the kids and the patients, and there's all sorts of opportunities for you to be able to maintain volunteer hours. So every hospital is different. My hospital does it a little bit differently, and they have a lot of requirements for us to do to be able to maintain our clinical license. And usually if you want to go up the clinical ladder, it's something that isn't mandatory, but it is highly recommended, especially if you want to grow in your career, then usually people like to climb up the clinical ladder. And like I said, the teaching does not stop there. A lot of times we have to do skills lab as well. So every year we usually have a day where we do skills lab and practice on skills that we need to brush up on or learn any new information that we need to know. And a lot of times our clinical nurse educators will teach us some new information based off of current research as well. And my hospital does provide opportunities for CEs, and they will have courses and classes, and usually we'll have lectures provided by some of the doctors at our hospital, and they try to teach us some new information. And it's also a chance for you to learn new things and gain knowledge on current research. So I love going to the classes that they provide in my hospital as a new opportunity for me to gain some new knowledge and learn something new. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and let me know down in the comments below what your hospital requires you in order to maintain working where you are currently. Do you have to join committees as well? Do you guys have a clinical ladder? And what do you have to do to be able to maintain that? So I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. 'Cause anywhere you feels right.